Thank you. The Committee to Protect Journalists is seriously concerned about the actions taken by the Department of Justice and the ongoing efforts to subpoena Jim, which could have a chilling effect on the U.S. media and journalists if it has not indeed already had that impact. CPJ was founded in 1981 by a group of U.S. correspondents who realized that they could not ignore the plight of colleagues abroad whose reporting put them at risk on a daily basis. Since then, CPJ has promoted press freedom worldwide and defended the rights of journalists to report the news without fear of reprisal. Last year, we decided that the crackdown on leak investigations and revelations about the extent of surveillance in a post-9/11 world necessitated us to look inward and weigh in on the threats to press freedom in the United States. And this is why we are here today in support of Jim. And as a former colleague of Jim's at the New York Times, I am also personally happy to be here in solidarity with his efforts to protect his confidential sources and the integrity of the journalistic practice. The Obama administration has pursued 8 prosecutions of leakers under the Espionage Act. That's more than twice the total number of such prosecutions since the law was enacted than any other administration all combined. And the subpoena requiring Jim's testimony is part of the broader crackdown on leaks and whistleblowers, as you've heard. A CPJ special report published last October concluded that the Obama administration's aggressive prosecution of leakers of classified information, revelations about broad surveillance programs, and moves to stem the routine disclosure of information to the press shows that the president has fallen far short of his campaign promise to head the most open government in U.S. history. Several journalists interviewed for the report told CPJ that leak investigations and surveillance revelations had made government sources fearful to talk about sensitive information, and prosecutions such as those of Jim have had a profoundly detrimental impact on the practice of journalism and, as you've heard, on the First Amendment. Publicly speculating about bringing charges of espionage or prosecutions more generally of journalists for doing their job serves to intimidate not only the individual journalist, but journalists more broadly, and has a serious chilling effect on the press. This is likely to be even stronger among journalists who do not have the backing and protection of a major media organization with legal resources. Revelations about targeted surveillance and hacking of journalists and media outlets is also deeply problematic, and you heard those described earlier. And having read Jim's affidavit explaining why he cannot testify and detailing the extent of government harassment and surveillance of his electronic communications, it is clear that if he is forced to testify, he would likely put at risk the confidentiality of his source. Furthermore, these type of aggressive prosecutions send a dangerous signal to governments elsewhere that would seek to use national security and anti-state charges as a cover for clamping down on journalists and press freedom. According to CPJ research, nearly 60% of imprisoned journalists worldwide are imprisoned on anti-state charges, such as subversion or terrorism. That is far higher than any other type of charge, such as defamation or insult, and it is a favorite of repressive regimes who see little value in a free press. Furthermore, undermining the principle of source protection and the idea that journalists like doctors and others have the right to keep sources confidential has implications for the robust practice of journalism. Indeed, in 2012, the Justice Department argued that reporters' privilege should not apply in national security cases and compared journalists to someone receiving drugs from a dealer. Preventing journalists from being able to promise confidentiality to their sources undermines the key aspect of journalism that is central to so much reporting on issues that are central to the public interest, like national security, like anti-terrorism, and are central to holding government accountable and to the democratic process. The U.S. government's ongoing legal pursuit of Jim sends a terrifying message to the 124 journalists jailed worldwide on anti-state charges and detracts from its normative moral power abroad. I don't think that the United States wants to join Cuba in becoming the only other country in the Western Hemisphere to have an imprisoned journalist. And that's what's at risk here. It is much harder for the U.S. to be taken seriously when it advocates for press freedom and journalistic rights abroad when they are abridged at home. Governments have many obligations to enforce the law, to protect citizens, to prevent attacks, but they also have an obligation to uphold the Constitution and to uphold democratic principles upon which this society is built and to ensure the functioning of the democratic process in which the press plays a central role. The Committee to Protect Journalists calls on the United States Department of Justice to withdraw a subpoena seeking to force journalist James Risen to give testimony that would reveal a confidential source.